Swami Sachidananda Bharathi has traveled widely all over India and the world. He was one of the spiritual leaders who represented India in the Millennium World Peace Summit of Religious and Spiritual Leaders organized in August 2000 at New York by the United Nations.
Puja Moolam Guru Padam Andra Moolam Guru with all of you came up, and I happily and gladly accepted it. I am at present stationed at Cochin. I have an ashram there, Dharma Bharati Ashram. I also have another ashram in Andhra Pradesh, Vishajyoti Ashram, which is a newly taken up ashram. I have two institutions with which I am associated, a school of forgiveness and reconciliation, and an institute of peace and value education. I have an organization called Dharma Bharati Mission, which is involved in what second freedom struggle of India. So that way my involvement are multifaceted, but my focus has been always on the teachers, because my guru Swami Ringanathananda at one stage in my life told me, you cannot do everything and you cannot deal with everyone. And the most important group of people who can influence others, especially the future generation, and who can spread a new message, are the teachers. So focus on them, that will be the best thing you can do. So it is from that I developed a concept, teachers enrichment program. How to help teachers? All of us are in that area. I myself being a teacher in the Air Force, Force Commander for the Air Force Academy, which was essentially a teaching job. So teachers, we have to interact with the younger generation. And often, school teachers have a greater responsibility because the younger ones take it for granted whatever we say is God's words. The college is more challenging because they question. They often question the challenges. So everything we say may not go. But then it's also a different experience to be interacting with the grown-up and asking, rather answering their questions or asking them questions. So teachers, or the most effective group through which we can spread a message or we can share a dream, whatever. In our Indian tradition, the three people are something like the channels of grace. The mother, the father and the teacher. Matha, Pitha, Guru, Deva. So often what happens is that today motherhood is for sale, so is fatherhood, and the guruhood, the teacherhood, or the sale. But these are, in a way, missions, divine missions, which cannot be sold, it cannot be exchanged for monetary gain. I am yet to find a mother who would receive a salary for her motherhood. Now, I suppose all of your mothers here, isn't it? Anyone who is not married, ladies here? Not yet married. Others are all mothers. You have a son, madam? How old is he?
He's 26.
26, already employed. Yeah. And only one son? Second one is how old? Also employed? Employed. Whose sons are not yet employed? Yeah.
Yeah.
Obviously. Name. Dishwa. Suppose Yoga grows up and is very well possible. Workplace or at home, you know, the whether at home or the place or the public life, everywhere, this is a central issue, interpersonal relationship. Then the second part of it, we will deal with something what we call the enlightened leadership. There are many kinds of leadership. Charismatic leadership is there. Enlightened leadership is something a teacher must inculcate. So, in our so-called satsang, basically it's a satsang. We are seekers of truth, fellow seekers of truth. To find out the truth, what are the issues, challenges, and to see how we can deal with truthfully. We are there as a satsang. So, when we talk about this relationship, the most important thing that comes to me is to understand myself so that I can understand others. Because if we don't understand ourselves, how do we understand others? Like all the great masters, like Jesus says, love your neighbor as you love yourself. Or any other scripture says, do unto others what you want others to do unto you. So loving your neighbor as you love yourself. There is no love you have in your heart for your own self. How will you ask us to understand ourselves? If we have to understand others, and this understanding is very important in our relationship. And what is understanding? Understanding another person is nothing but discovering a part of yourself in the other person. When I say I understand you, means I discover something of myself in you. Isn't it? So understanding means discovering ourselves in others. And how can we discover ourselves in others when we are not discovered ourselves within our own self? It's important. So this understanding others demands that we know ourselves. And to know ourselves, we must also see what are the yearnings of every human heart. Because each one of us, every one of us, we have some deep yearnings, which is common to all of us. For example, the yearning for love. Every one of us, old and young, man, woman, married or unmarried, all of us want to be loved, isn't it? All of us want to be loved. And without this love, it becomes miserable, whether it's at home or in the workplace or in the public place, anywhere, we want to be loved. And children cannot grow unless there is love, a loving atmosphere at home. Students cannot blossom out to their fullness unless there is a loving atmosphere in the class or in the college or school, wherever they are. So there are deepest yearnings of the human heart. Now suppose I ask you, what is, according to you, the three or four deep yearnings of every human heart? Can anyone guess? What would you say there? The four deepest yearnings of the human heart. Peace. Yearning for peace, yeah. Contentment.
Forgiveness.
Forgiveness.
Money.
Happiness. Kindness. There are certain things which is not common to all of us. For example, yearning for money. It is not common to everyone. I can tell you, I don't yearn for money. I am a sannyasi, I am not bothered about money. It is not common. But I do need love. So, we have to see that the yearnings which are common to all of us. Everywhere. Love is okay, and contentment is okay. Food, yes, food. Huh? What is it?
Knowledge.
knowledge, yes. Garden City, City of Knowledge. Garden City College, a city, a College of Knowledge, yes. Sometimes you hear that every day. Yeah. The knowledge is here. Yeah, but if you really look into it, put all this together, and then try to pick up the four, probably all of us will agree on this fact of love, isn't it? All of us will agree. There is another thing which I found many of us, I mean, in fact, all of us need, that is acceptance of what we are. See, most of us, we try to change others according to our, need. We don't accept others as they are. Husband and wife relationship, the husband loves the wife when she is well made up and, all those things. Not in the shabby dress and, the conditions are laid out. But the wife, cooking and cleaning and baby sitting, all these things, sometimes she is not all that at their best. So the understanding, it diminishes in a way that mutual thing, like, because we are not able to accept the reality of life and the person. So there is a deep yearning for all of us to be accepted as we are. Accepted as we are. Can we say the common yearning of human heart? Is it a common thing? It's common to all of us. Then I find another thing, which I'm sure you will also agree to that. All of us need to be respected for what we are. That's the dignity, the respect. Don't treat us shabbily. We need to be given a certain amount of dignity for what we are. Whatever we be, we need to be given that kind of a little respect and dignity, and all of us want that. Am I right? You can say these four yearnings: yearning for love, yearning for acceptance, yearning for dignity or respect, and yearning for equality. Can we say all these four are common to all of us? And one thing we will notice, that most of our problems in interpersonal relationship comes when we are not able to satisfy that. How do I get it? By giving, yes. But normally what happens is that when we want to get it, there are two ways of getting it. One is by phone or whatever it is. That is how we get things done, especially in the corporate world. The competition is so tough to get a thing. So here, to get love, we cannot get it by. Though, in the psychology, we learn about the games people play. You might have read that book also, isn't it? The games people play. To get. Many a time, when we pretend sickness, it may be an effort to get the attention of the other person. Like, I remember my daughter Deepthi, when she was young. One day she said, "Daddy, headache. At the age of 6, headache," she said. She's 4, I think she's 4, yeah. Because my daughter had all the things, and I was good in massaging. So I would take little oil and do the massage for her. My daughter's been sick. So I brought the oil, made her sit down and all the things. I asked her, "Where is the headache you have?" And she said, all this. So the headache was it really headache? No. It was only an effort to get that attention from the father. And many a time this is what happens in our relationship also. My friend, mother used to have problem, chest pain, and sometimes even up to heart attack on Saturdays. This is very interesting. So he came to me, told me that time, "Swamiji, you must come home and pray." I said, "What's it?" "My mother, she has this problem. I've been taking her to doctor and all this. And so many times we went, but this comes again and again." So I agreed, okay, I'll come. because he was very dear to my heart, this friend of mine. But on the way driving, I asked him something about to know this mother's problem. One thing I discovered, this happens only on Saturdays. So this clicked to me, why only on Saturdays? Then I found out both my friend and his wife, they are both working. The only time they are at home is Saturday and Sunday. So Saturday morning is the time this problem begins. Because the old lady wants little attention, because this Saturday, the young couple, they will go out. They will go socializing. They may go for a film or some party or get together. And the old lady is left alone. And Saturday they will take the children also. And the servant will take care of the old lady and okay. So this was the old lady's reaction. Saturday morning that she will... Actually it is psychosomatic sickness, real sickness. Psychosomatic sickness is also very, very, very real. So the doctor will see, yes, serious. She is to be taken care of. So their holiday, their party is gone, they have to sit at home, take care of the mother. And the mother is very happy, and by Sunday evening everything is okay. Because she, in the office, the co-workers, in the staff room, the teachers, all we have this kind of tendency to get the attention, to get these things that we need. So in other words, interpersonal relationship is essentially an effort to satisfy these deepest yearnings of the human heart. Is that right? Do you agree to this idea? Yeah? Interpersonal relationship is essentially a relationship that's seeking for satisfaction of the deepest yearnings of the human heart, which is common to all of us. So it becomes a science by itself. The science, that's why psychology, the psychiatry, all these are developed in this, based on this simple basic principles. Now there's one problem which we find. I want to love. Really, I want to love. But I'm not able to do that. Do we face such a problem sometimes? We want to be good. But somehow we again fall back into the old habits. We make New Year resolutions, isn't it? We make New Year resolutions. What beautiful resolutions we make. By maybe 2 weeks' time, 3 weeks' time, all those resolutions are gone. Back to the old habits. Am I right? Or if you have an anger towards a person, that person has done something harmful to you or spoke something negative about you, you will find it very difficult to love that person. Even though intellectually you want to forgive and you want to love that person, emotionally, in reality, we are not able to do it. And many of us find this, I want to be good, I want to love others, but somehow I'm not able to love others. And this is where this concept of forgiveness and reconciliation comes in. I told you I started a school of forgiveness and reconciliation. This was the motivation because in my interaction with people over the years, I found one of the core problems faced by most of us in our relationship is inability to forgive and reconcile with people. And if we don't forgive and reconcile within our own self, all other things get affected, including our physical health. Including our physical health. I'll tell you, I was a case study, a thing that happened. I went outside, one lady came hurrying after me. I said, Swamiji, can I speak to you for a minute? I said, sure. So I went to the drawing room, where she said, Swamiji, you must pray for me. I said, what happened? I'm not able to sleep, Swamiji. I get headache. and I get stomach pain, I get so many things I don't know.